Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Headed back to Phineas's lab. And we're not going to turn him in.
We have successfully arrived at Phineas's orbital lab, Captain, and we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you like to do the honors?
I think you can handle it. Just to remind us, now that Phineas knows Minister Clark's been hoarding dimethyl sulfoxide byzantium, he just needs you to get to the city of steel easy. Well, we did that. Now that you have the dimethyl sulfoxide, which Minister Clark was not himself hoarding, rendezvous with Phineas's lab to plan your next moves. It was actually... Where was he? In any case, he's... not currently hoarding it now. He's a prisoner in his own home. I'm too encumbered to travel alone. Providing an Ellie, I guess. Negotiate with Sprats for territory. Install Sisty Pig Slurry Catchment. And so you also have Adjutant Sophia Akande has asked you to help her track down Phineas Wells. Head to Wells' lab and send the board a tracking signal from his terminal. Find Wells' communication terminal, send a track signal, blah, blah, blah. We're not doing that. I cannot in good conscience do something like that. I wonder if I can tell him about it. Phineas!
I've kept myself busy in your absence, optimized my formula. I'm now confident I can revive the remaining colonists.
Awesome!
All I need now is the dimethyl sulfoxide. I'll take as much as you can give me.
Good point with this one, but... might as well get on with bringing the colonists back. Maybe they can help. I found your chemicals in the ministry. The board was testing them on human subjects.
Human test subjects? Oh, that's grotesque. That's unthinkable. That's exactly what I'd expect out of the board.
Yeah, I had to extract a certain amount. These are all the chemicals I could get. Any more and I would have actually killed the subjects. Oh, that's no good. Also, the colony is on the verge of collapse, and the board's been trying to cover it up.
I know! I've suspected as much for years. Of course, I don't expect the board to do a thing about it. They've been driving our colony to the brink of destruction for decades. The board's mismanagement put our colony on the road to collapse. If we don't put a stop to them, thousands of colonists are going to die.
It gets worse. The chairman's planning on freezing every worker in Halcyon.
Hold on. Let me see if I understand this correctly. You're saying that Halcyon's on the brink of total collapse, and the chairman's plan to save all of us is to save himself? I always knew Halcyon was heading toward a systems collapse, but I never imagined we were already there. The board made this crisis, and now they want to solve it by freezing the rest of us? That's not a plan. That's a goddamn escape clause!
Pretty much.
Do you realize what this means for the Hope? For your fellow colonists? The board's going to kill them all. Toss them out into space, just to make room in their hibernation chambers.
We need to think about this. There has to be something we can do.
Short of lining up every member of the board and shooting them in the back of the head.
That's an idea.
On the Hope. Scientists, engineers, artists, the brightest minds Earth ever sent us, uncorrupted by the board. The board's going to dispose of them all and transform the Hope into a prison for the rest of us. They're likely on their way to the Hope as we speak. We need to get to those colonists before the board. I have enough chemicals to start reviving a few of them, but no easy way to get them off the Hope.
There's a way. It's not exactly safe, but we could skip the Hope into the system. There has to be something to this. Skip the Hope. Getting it closer to the board?
Merciful gibbering law, you're a genius!
I'm not even sure what I mean.
We bring the Hope to us. Skip the entire ship across the distance of colony space.
Oh.
Right next to my lab.
To this system, which is far away from the board. Okay. I'm glad I have these skills. As I'm being serious. the Hope's probably damaged. We'll have to route power from the... or route power from the unreliable.
Yes. Yes, exactly. You're a step ahead of me. But I perceive the shape of your plan.
Aha.
If we link up the Hope to the unreliable, then use your navigational computer to calculate a reasonably safe vector, we can skip the entire colony ship into the rings of Terra 2.
I don't know much about skip drives, not the physics anyhow. I do know the Hope's real massive. How's our bitty little ship supposed to skip it?
Excellent question, my sharp-witted mechanic. You will use your own ship to power up the Hope's skip drive. Your navigational computer can handle the rest.
I've got a healthy disregard for personal safety, but this sounds crazy, even to me.
Well, should be right up your alley, then.
Your instincts are correct. By any reasonable definition of sanity, this plan is crazy. Isn't it wonderful? You'll need to switch on the Hope's auxiliary power using the unreliable. Then head to the bridge. Your navigational computer, Ada, should be able to activate the Hope's skip drive. Once you've skipped the Hope next to my lab, I'll have easy access to the frozen colonists. I can start reviving them immediately.
But just wait a second, I've got some questions.
Certainly. How can I help?
People aren't going to notice a gigantic colony ship slamming into the rings of Terra 2?
Unlikely. The Hope is as massive as the Groundbreaker, but compared to the rings of Terra 2, positively minuscule. The board might notice, possibly, depending on the position of their heads relative to the depth of their collective posteriors.
Should I expect any resistance?
It wouldn't surprise me. When I pulled you out of the Hope, the board nearly intercepted me. I expect they stepped up security since my little act of larceny.
Just so we clear, you know skip drives aren't supposed to be used like this.
Skip drives were never designed to be used within a system, but I skipped my ship across Halcyon when I rescued you, and that turned out fine. Mostly.
Mostly.
That is, I ruined my ship and nearly killed myself in the process, but the maneuver was well within acceptable margins of risk. You'll be fine. You'll be fine.
Famous last words. All right, no more questions. I'm ready.
I know you're wondering why I'm doing all this. Why I believe the people on the Hope are the answer to the colony's problems.
Because they can come up with a solution.
The Hope is carrying some of humanity's most brilliant thinkers.
That's a lot of experience.
Engineers, experts in their field. If we work together, we can still find a way to save Halcyon. The board would have us believe Halcyon is beyond saving. I choose to believe otherwise. If there's even the slightest chance we can save Halcyon from oblivion, then we have to take it.
So our board reputation decreased, and we can now travel to the Hope from the unreliable. The adjutant, just so you know, asked me to plant a tracking signal in your lab, but I'm not going to do it.
You absolutely should.
I can't tell if you're being sarcastic.
Sarcasm. The last refuge of the witless.
I beg your pardon?
The adjutant must have sent you some kind of tracking code. If you don't use the code, she'll suspect you betrayed her. I think you should use the code and send a corrupted tracking signal. That should buy me some time.
You sure you're okay with this?
The enemy is bound to discover my hideout sooner or later. I'm prepared for that eventuality. This is just my way of buying myself a little time. Use my communications terminal to corrupt the tracking signal. While the board busies themselves trying to decipher it, I'll have plenty of time to prepare my defenses.
Okay. Don't want to talk about the Hope some more?
Certainly. How can I help?
Nope, that's it for now. Ooh! Yeah. We can talk. What's up?
So we're really gonna do this?
Apparently.
I've seen lots of crazy, Captain, but Phineas is in a class of his own.
I like him.
Do you really think he knows what he's doing? Sending us to skip the Hope into Teratu's orbit right under the board's nose?
Not sure, but it's our best chance.
There's a sobering thought. Makes me want to drink. I think this whole plan's insane, but it'll make a good story, you know, if we survive. Speaking of, I get that Phineas thinks he's saving the colony, but what about you? Why risk your neck on this crazy scheme?
What else am I gonna do? For better or worse, my future is tied to Halcyon now.
Makes you wish for a fancier ship with bigger engines. Don't know about you, but I'd be out of here if I could. Still, all this depends on the other Hope colonists. Are they gonna pull us out of the shit? Or are we all just gonna leave a bigger, uglier stain on this corner of the galaxy?
We won't know until we make it happen.
Well, whenever you're ready to do this, I'm with you. Anything else?
Nope. You have anything to say, Parvati?
Where are we headed?
Okay. So I guess we're doing this. Phineas mentions you could send a corrupted tracking signal to buy him some time. So this isn't anything I want to delay on doing and then do it. I mean, what if we just do it later? I can send a tracking signal, the corrupted tracking signal. Installing surveillance tracking signal and relay, running cacophony protocol, replicating artificial interference, modifying signal noise ratio, establishing connection, error, signal status weak, board surveillance protocol failed, signal fidelity has been compromised. The terminal will attempt to establish a new connection once every cycle.
That should do it. You've bought me more than enough time.
Do we have one cycle? Is that what's going on?
I won't wish you luck on the Hope. Can't rely on luck. Rigorous calculations and sound logic. That's the ticket.
I want luck too.
What's on your mind?
Nothing. Nothing, honey. Sophia said she'd contact you as soon as her office picks up Wells' location. Head back to your ship and see if Sophia has a message for you. Phineas Wells has asked you to skip the Hope to Terra 2. Land your ship in one of the Hope's docking bays. Right, I want to take care of these other things first. Just because that looks like end-game kind of stuff. I love the welcome mat. Makes the place very homey, somehow. Okay, maybe not that homey. Alright, so see if she has a message for us. Hopefully not yet.
A reminder to all crew members. There is only one toilet on the ship. You have a message from Adjutant Sophia Akande.
I'm impressed, Captain. I almost expected you wouldn't go through with it.
Oh yeah?
Unfortunately, Dr. Wells found a way to corrupt the signal before we could pinpoint his location.
Oh, funny that.
Still, it's only a matter of time before we find him. come visit me in Byzantium. We need to have a talk about the future of this colony.
You can now travel to Adjutant Akane's. Why did it decrease? They think he corrupted the signal. Why did my reputation decrease? Come visit me in Byzantium. You need to talk about the future of this colony. Yes, after I run all over the place getting, like, armor and looking for beacons and stuff. Byzantium's a big place.
Meet me in my office. I've authorized your ship at my personal landing pad.
Mm. Adjutant Akande has ended her call.
Wow.
Rather rudely, if I might say, considering she didn't sign off. Will there be anything else, Captain?
Nope. We're not going there yet. Sophia was pleased with your results, but somehow my board reputation decreased, and requests that you come see her in Byzantium. I could see it decreasing if they find when they find out the truth. Return to Lilya Hagen. Lilya will want to know what happened to Dr. Chartrand's estate. You chose to spare Dr. Chartrand's life. Yeah, she's not going to be very happy. She's a board-sponsored chimerist, a scientist who manipulates the nucleus of plants and creatures from Earth to survive on colony worlds. Right. And then this is on Fallbrook. Emerald Vale. Outfits. Iconoclast, Marauder, and Space. Alright, to the Groundbreaker. This is nearby.
We've arrived at the Groundbreaker.
We sure have. I need the badasses to come with me. Ellie's kind of a badass. But I'm thinking Max and Naoka, maybe? Kind of torn between Naoka and Ellie. Yeah. Because Lilya Hagen's not going to be pleased. Was a philosophist. I never noticed that on the helmet. Yes, picking up things that belong to other individuals is a crime. Just don't get caught. Did we find out? Celeste. Alright. I need spacer suits. I figure we might get them here. I think someone said we'd find them here.
Those lemon slap your whole family tonight.
See, maybe here. Spacer's choice?
I received a very interesting message from Gladys Kilkelly not too long ago. You know, about the toothpaste?
Oh, the diet toothpaste?
The Spacer's Choice trustees will be pleased. I might even get an extra meal voucher. And I hear I got you to thank. So thanks.
How would you eat? Be bold, Martin. Ask for two meal vouchers.
I don't think boldness is really part of our brand. I'd need to check my contract. Have a look.
Spacer stuff. Spacer stuff. Well, I'm not sure, so let's sell some stuff first. I'm gonna hold on to that. I don't want to sell my mandibular rearranger. That is some good armor right there. Lockpick plus 10. Plus 5. I think I'm gonna save this stuff. This is tactical time dilation recharge. So wait, 200% natural health. Oh yeah, I don't like these things. Cysty chops. Huh. Did I sell some of my stuff by mistake? Hardened armor rating. Get rid of some of these things. Fun times barrel. All right. Mr. Power. Thug kit. I have a good amount of money now. Ugh. She over there. She's the one.
It get cooler in here? I swear they had the heat turned way the hell up.
I fixed that. She doesn't sell any armor. Where else am I supposed to find a spacer gear? I know where to find a kind of class in Marauder. Suit of armor and headpiece. Just don't know about spacer. Are those like sublight people? Sublight.
C&P chicken and potatoes. At C&P, we know our C&P.
Is that what CMP stands for? Chicken and potatoes? Never made the connection. Chicken and potatoes! Alright, this lady's not gonna be happy with us. Hi.
I got no clue what half the junk on this desk is for, except the lamp. Improvised weapon.
Well, good luck with that. Hello?
Is it done?
I spoke to Chartrand. I am not going to kill her.
Well, damn. Contractor grew a conscience. As your employer, I'm both angry and disappointed. I'll add that to your file.
Go right ahead.
Technically, I owe you an exit interview. Care to justify your betrayal of our species, or are we finished here?
You misunderstood Chartrand's research. She's our best shot at survival in Halcyon.
You're awfully quick to trust someone who offed her colleagues and called it a good start. Out of my office. We're done.
I like it, Captain. Let's go before we have to paint this office with her blood.
What a surprise. Seems we're no longer wanted here.
You two are supposed to help me out.
I said get out.
Fine. Whatever. I would have liked to have the chance to explain. Who's selling armor? Ike's Armory. That would be a good start.
Ooh, you're here. It'll do a lot for my credit in the promenade if people see you buying something. So, what'll it be?
Kind of hampering my style, you waving at me. Can you act more aloof next time? What's spacer stuff? Space aviator glasses. It has the word space in it. You can ask him about
itching to whack someone over the head. We can help with that.
Tell me more about your wares.
Everything I sell is fresh from the forge. Technically, the metal formed billions of years ago, but it's freshly in this shape.
Right. Spacer stuff. So this is a completed quest now? What was it called again? You chose to spare Dr. Eva Chartrand's life. In exchange, she agreed to help carry out Phineas' plans for Halcyon. Oh, yeah, they're gonna get together and have a meeting of the minds or something? And talk about that. Lilya wasn't pleased, and you parted ways less than amicably. For some reason, this isn't checked off. We did do it. That's X'd because we didn't do it. You know what? I'm pretty sure she said spacer. Stop waving. Spacer stuff. Well, I know she said spacer stuff. Are you drinking? I think she said come to the Groundbreaker for it. But now I want to actually look back at my video and make absolutely sure what she might have said. Oh, we have to level up too. Let me level up and then we'll... You want to get that up. No one else has to level up. Okay. Alright. I'm back to watch my video back to see if I'm buying elite troop armor or what the hell I'm doing. Okay. She said your spacer's gear. She did say here on the Groundbreaker, but not spacer's choice.
Hey, look who it is. What'll it be?
Ordnance controls. Hold on. Okay. Ah. Lightweight leather jacket, a spacer's favorite. An outfit typically worn by spacers. Well, that lightweight spacer's gear. Spacer's favorite. Who else would make this but spacer's choice? Not spacer's choice. So, there's reports of call. Spacer's choice. Spacer's choice. Padded helm. Lightweight spacer's helmet. Spacer's goggles. Okay. So get this. Right? Shouldn't be expensive. No. Alright, so as far as anything else. Spacer's gear. This is 51. I wonder if we get points for getting the best kind of thing. Spacer's favorite. This is pristine. Okay. So maybe that will suffice for here.
Still betting on the toss ball series? I know you were trying to stop.
We can't stop, mister. I guess we're going back to Emerald Vale first. For that beacon. These are busy quests. Go all over the place. Pad out the run time of the game a little bit. Yeah, I'm a little jaded. This is something like Mass Effect Andromeda would have you
Captain,
do.
Captain, I hope Dr. Wells has not dragged you into one of his irrational schemes again. My diagnosis of his mental stability is not flattering.
Noted. Find the second beacon somewhere far to the north of the Edgewater landing pad.
Sending a corrupted tracking signal to the board was quite clever, if I might say, Captain.
I thought you didn't approve.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
I thought you had some stuff to talk about. Never mind.
Goodbye.
Bye. Alright. Edgewater landing pad.
We are now in orbit above Edgewater, Captain.
We sure are. Let's go find that beacon. How about Ellie and Max? The infamous plasma cutter.
Can we talk?
You want to talk again? We just talked before. Oh, that's far. I guess we'll come from the Emerald Vale Community Center. You want to talk again? Hold on a second. Okay.
Something on your mind?
You just asked if we could talk. Okay. While we're here, we can kill some marauders and take their stuff. We haven't been here in forever. I'm sure these people have come back. Where are we supposed to be going? Unveil beacon this way. Actually surprised there's nobody about. Don't trust it. What? I hear a beastie. Might be down in there, though. Oh, I definitely hear stuff. I think they're down in there. Marauders!